فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى I want to share with you a benefit or extract benefits بإذن الله الكريم from the statement of a great noble imam, al-imam Yahya ibn Abi Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala. This statement, al-imam Muslim rahimahullah, he narrated in his sahih, Abu Nu'aym ibn Abdul Barr in Jami' Bayan al-Ilm wa Fadlih, al-Bayhaqi in his Madkhal, and al-imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi in his kitab al-Faqih wal-Mutafaqih. So this hadith is a sound and authentic hadith. And this athar, more like, is لا يستطاع العلم براحة الجسم. That knowledge cannot be gained with a relaxed body. In other words, فالعلم لا ينال براحة الجسم بل لا بد من الجد. You will not be able to gain knowledge whilst you are relaxed. You're in a cozy and a comfortable lifestyle. But rather what is needed from you is that you strive and you put a lot of effort in, my beloved brothers and sisters. And that is exactly what the Imam here is trying to point out. Which is, knowledge is something that requires muthabarah, inayah. It requires effort. It requires hard work. It requires hifdhul waqt, safeguarding and protecting your time. It requires with all of that sincerity which comes from the heart. It also requires the tawfiq, the aid, the support, the assistance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I've traveled a lot enough to different countries. I've been to Egypt, I've been to Saudi Arabia, I've been to Kuwait, I've been to other countries in the world. And I've seen students of knowledge who've left their countries. They've come from Western countries, from America, England, the Scandinavian countries. And they sign up for universities, prestigious universities, such as Medina University, Jamiat Malik Saud, Jamiat Malik Imam. And they all go there to study and to learn. They also go to other countries, Egypt, for instance, to learn Arabic or to learn Islamic studies, even enroll into Azhar University. And what I've realized is that a lot of these students, they come back with really not much. And the reason is because is that they wanted to gain knowledge with comfort. They wanted to gain knowledge with a luxury lifestyle. And these are two things that conflate with one another. It's two things that go against each other. Gaining knowledge, but in a very comfortable and in a very luxurious way, it's like fire and water. And that's the reality of it. And the statement of here, al-Imam Yahya ibn Abi Kathir, sums up that concept. Which is that if you want to gain knowledge, and you really want to get it, you really are serious about it, you have to get rid of this luxury lifestyle that you're all about. But if you don't want to gain knowledge, then live your luxury life and comfort and you gain it. I'm going to, inshallah ta'ala, bring to your attentions why Imam Muslim rahimahullah, he brought this statement of his, Yahya ibn Abi Kathir in his Sahih. He brought it mu'allaqan, by the way. And when he brought it, what was the objective behind it? Because there's no relationship between where the chaptering in which he brought it in and the statement here. So scholars tried to explain why. Al-Imam Al-Qadhi Iyadh rahimahullah, in his kitab Al-Mu'lim, the second volume, page 577, he mentions why Imam Muslim brought this in his Sahih. He says, قَالَ بَعْضُ شُيُوخِنَا Some of our teachers, our scholars, our shuyukh, they said, إِنَّ مُسْلِمًا رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ Imam Muslim, رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ أَعْجَبَهُ مَا ذُكِرَ فِي الْبَابِ وَعَرَفَ مِقْدَارَ مَا تَعَبَ فِي تَحْصِيلِهِ وَجَمْعِهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ فَأَدْخَلَ بَيْنَهَا الْخَبَرَ تَنْبِيهًا عَلَى هَذَا وَأَنَّهُ لَمْ يُحَصِّلْ مَا ذُكِرَ إِلَّا بَعْدَ مَشَقَّةٍ وَتَعَبٍ فِي الطَّلَبِ وَهُوَ بَيِّنٌ وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ Al-Imam Qadi Iyad rahimahullah, he said, some of our teachers said that Imam Muslim, what fascinated him was that which was mentioned in that chaptering, the narrations that he brought had actually fascinated him and it amazed him. And he remembered the effort and the hard work he went through in order to collect all these narrations, to bring them together and to combine them and to compile them. And so in between these narrations, he placed this hadith in there and he put it there to bring to his own attention and remind himself that all of this was not gained and it was not received illa ba'da mashaqqatin, except through after hard work and effort. Wa ta'abin fit talab, and hard work was put in looking for these narrations. And the same thing is Al-Allamah Al-Sanusi rahimahullah in his Mukammilul Ikmal. In the second volume, page 548, he mentions the same. قَوْلُهُ لَا يُسْتَطَاعُ الْعِلْمُ بِرَاحَةِ الْجِسْمِ قِيلَ هِيَ فِي وَجْهِ مُنَاسَبَتِهِ لِحَدِيثِ الْبَابِ أَنَّ مُسْلِمًا رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ أَعْجَبَهُ حُسْنَ سِيَاقِ هَذِهِ الطُّرُقِ الَّتِي ذَكَرَهَا لِحَدِيثِ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ بْنِ عُمَرَ That what fascinated him, Imam Muslim, was the beauty of how these chains of narrations in which he has mentioned pertaining to the hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar. وَكَثْرَةِ فَوَائِدِهَا and the excessive benefits that are in that narration. وَالتَّلْخِيصِ فَوَائِدِهَا وَمَا اشْتَمَلَتْ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ الْفَوَائِدِ فِي الْأَحْكَامِ وَغَيْرِهَا And that which it consists of in terms of benefits in its rulings. فَنَبَّهَا Then he pointed out, عَلَىٰ أَنَّ مَنْ لَهُ رَغْبَةٌ فِي تَحْصِيلِ الْعِلْمِ And because of that, Muslim then reminded that anyone who wants to gain knowledge like that and have that knowledge with him, فَلْيُعَانِقِ التَّعَبْ وَلْيَهْجُرِ الرَّاحَةِ He should hug what? He should hug tiredness. وَلْيَهْجُرِ الرَّاحَةِ And he has to boycott relaxing. So actually hug tiredness, as though tiredness is something that you can hug. Meaning be consistently with tiredness. And also boycott and relaxation. Then, my beloved brothers and sisters, man arada tahsilu, anyone who wants, faman arada tahsil al-rutbati al-aliyah, my beloved brothers and sisters who are listening, if you want to gain a high level in knowledge, by knowing ma'rifatul ilm al-shar'i, by knowing the jurisprudent rulings of the religion, then spend your time in it. فَيَكْثُرُ اشْتِغَالُهُ بِهِ Spend your time in it. وَيُتْعِبُ جِسْمَهُ فِي الْاِعْتِنَاءِ بِتَحْصِيرِهِ And be one who tires his body in trying to gain this knowledge. وَاللَّهِ فَإِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزِ الْعَظِيمِ Because the great prosperity and good that you ever might be looking for is in that. فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ In this world and the hereafter. شَيْخُ شَيْخِنَا الْعَلَّامَ مُحَمَّدِ بْنُ صَالِحِ الْعُثَيْمِينَ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ In the Sharh Sahih Muslim, when he commented on the hadith, or the athar, sorry, of Yahya ibn Abi Kathir, لا يستطاع العلم براحة الجسم. Imam Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, al-Allama, al-Faqih al-Zaman, he says, beneficial points, wallahi. He says, هذا ينبغي أن يضاف إلى حلية طالب العلم. He said, this should be added onto the things that a student of knowledge should adorn himself with. And of course, it should be added onto the books that talk about the manners of a student of knowledge. And the book of Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd and the likes of those books. And then he goes on to say, فَلَا يُسْتَطَاعُ الْعِلْمُ بِرَاحَةِ الْجِسْمِ For verily, knowledge is not gained with a luxurious lifestyle, a body that is relaxed. فَالْإِنسَانُ الَّذِي يُرِيدُ أَن يَسْتَرِيحَ Any person who wants to relax, وَيَنَامَ And he wants to sleep, وَيَخْرُجَ إِلَى النُّزْهَةِ And he wants to go إِلَى النُّزَهِ Or he wants to go to the places, huh? watching the grass and beautiful sights. وَيَذْهَبُ مَعَ إِخْوَانِهِ And he wants to go with his friends. يَقْضِي الْوَقْتَ فِي غَيْرِ فَائِدَةٍ To spend time with them with no benefit whatsoever. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَسْتَطِيعُ الْعِلْمَ That person is not going to gain and he's not able for knowledge. He's not made for it. He's not cut for it. فَالْعِلْمُ لَا بُدَّ فِي تَحْصِيلِهِ مِنْ حِرْسٍ For gaining knowledge, there has to be striving. Effort. وَجِدٍ وَاجْتِهَادٍ وَيُقَالُ And it is said, اعطي العلم كلك تدرك بعضه Give knowledge all of yourself and it will give you in return some فإن أعطيته بعضك فاتك كله If you try to give knowledge some of yourself you will not receive anything you will lose out everything وهذا صحيح and the Sheikh said this is correct ولا سيما especially إذا عرف الإنسان من نفسه أنه يحتاج التعاهد العلمي Especially if the person realizes that he requires the ta'ahud of this knowledge. لِأَنَّ النَّاسِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ If you realize in yourself that Allah has given you the ability, and Allah has blessed you slightly, mashallah, your memory is a bit good, you're a fast learner, you pick up things quickly, the matter becomes even more serious for you. Because as we know, لِأَنَّ النَّاسِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ The Sheikh said the people are different in levels. فَمِنَ النَّاسِ From amongst the people are those من هو سريع الحفظ A person whose memorization is fast بطيء النسيان And it takes time for him to forget He doesn't easily forget what he memorizes ومن الناس And from the people are those من يكون بالعكس Who is the opposite to that which has been mentioned Meaning He's slow in memorization And he quickly forgets it ومن الناس And from the people are those من يتساوى حفظه ونسيانه His memorization And he's forgetting are both equal. مَنْ يَتَسَاوَى A person who is equal for him. حِفْظُهُ وَنِسْيَانُ The memorization and the forgetting. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ From amongst the people are those مَنْ هُوَ سَيِّئُ الْحِفْظُ A person whose memorization is bad. سَرِيعُ النِّسْيَانِ He forgets very fast. فَالْإِنسَانُ A person يَعْرِفُ مِن نَفْسِهِ He knows from himself. He knows himself. مَا لَا يَعْرِفُ غَيْرُهُ You know of yourself that which no one else knows of you. فَمَنْ عَرَفَ مِن نَفْسِهِ Anyone who realizes from himself أَنَّهُ يَحْتَاجُ إِلَى تَعَاهُدٍ فَلِيَتَعَاهَدْ Anyone who realizes that he's not like the normal people, that he needs extra work, then he should work hard. The one who realizes Allah has blessed him now, he also should strive because He can come out with a lot of benefits. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah, he said, this athar, this statement is in the kitab al-Faqih wal-Mutafaqih. And it is from the Sanad of Salih ibn Ahmad al-Tamimi, who said, Akhbarana Muhammad ibn Hamdan al-Tara'iqi, al-Tara'ifi, sorry. Who said, Akhbarana al-Rabi' ibn Sulaiman al-Muradi. Qala al-Shafi'iyu. Rabi' ibn Sulaiman al-Muradi narrated this from Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah. And it's, as I mentioned, it's from the tariq of Salih ibn Ahmad al-Tamimi, who narrated from Muhammad ibn Hamdan al-Tara'ifiyu. That Imam al-Shafi'i said, "An-nasu tabaqatun fil ilm." People are of levels when it comes to knowledge. "Mawqi'uhum min al-ilmi biqadri darajatihim fih." Their levels in knowledge is in accordance to their levels in it. He's going to explain that what he means by that. The people's levels in knowledge is the levels of efforts and hard works that they have previously put in. فَحَقٌ عَلَى طَلَبَةِ الْعِلْمِ بُلُوغُ غَايَةِ جَهْدِهِمْ فِي الْاِسْتِكْثَارِ مِنْ عِلْمِهِ وَالصَّبْرِ عَلَى كُلِّ عَارِضٍ دُونَ طَلَبِهِ وَإِخْلَاصِ النِّيَّةِ لِلَّهِ فِي إِدْرَاكِ عِلْمِهِ نَصًّا وَاسْتِنْبَاطًا وَالرَّغْبَةِ إِلَى اللَّهِ فِي الْعَوْنِ عَلَيْهِ فَإِنَّهُ لَا يُدْرَكُ خَيْرٌ إِلَّا بِعَوْنِهِ It is فَحَقٌ عَلَى طَلَبَةِ الْعِلْمِ It is upon the student of knowledge to reach the highest level of his efforts. In doing what? فِي الْاِسْتِكْثَارِ مِنْ عِلْمِهِ In gaining more knowledge. It's upon a student of knowledge that he strives excessively in reaching one who gains a lot of knowledge. وَالصَّبْرِ And to be patient عَلَى كُلِّ عَارِضٍ دُونَ طَلَبِهِ that the person is patient upon every obstacle and everything before that ultimate goal. وَإِخْلَاصُ نِيَّةِ لِلَّهِ. And that the person comes with sincerity for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. فِي إِدْرَاكِ عِلْمِهِ. In reaching his knowledge that he's looking for. Whether it is nassan in terms of textual evidences, memorization, when it comes to memorizing, wastimbatan, and also extracting rulings from it. وَالرَّغْبَةِ إِلَى اللَّهِ فِي الْعَوْنِ عَلَيْهِ. And also having desires in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in aiding you and supporting you. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يُدْرَكُ خَيْرٌ. Because a person will never reach good that they are looking for إِلَّا بِعَوْنِهِ, except that if they gain aid from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn Jama'a rahimahullah, in his kitab Tadhkiratu Sami', he mentions something, wallahi, that every one of us needs in mentioning that أَنَّ الْعِلْمَ لَا يُنَالُ إِلَّا بِالْإِجْتِهَادِ. That knowledge is not gained except with striving. He says, دَوَامُ الْحِرْصِ عَلَى ازْدِيَادِ بِمُلَازَمَةِ الْجِدِّ وَالْإِجْتِهَادِ وَالْمُوَاضَبَةِ عَلَى وَظَائِفِ الْأَوْرَادِ مِنَ الْعِبَادَةِ وَالْإِشْتِغَالِ وَالْإِشْغَالُ قِرَاءَةً وَإِقْرَاءً وَمُطَالَعَةً وَفِكْرًا وَتَعْلِيقًا وَحِفْظًا وَتَصْنِيفًا وَبَحْثًا وَلَا يُضَيِّعُ شَيْئًا مِنْ أَوْقَاتِ عُمْرِهِ فِي غَيْرِ مَا هُوَ بِصَدَدِهِ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ وَالْعَمَلِ إِلَّا بِقَدْرِ الضَّرُورَةِ مِنْ أَكْلٍ أَوْ شُرْبٍ أَوْ نَوْمٍ أَوْ إِسْتِرَاحَةٍ لِمَلَلٍ أَوْ أَدَاءِ حَقِّ زَوْجَةٍ أَوْ زَائِرٍ أَوْ تَحْصِيلِ قُوتٍ وَغَيْرِهِ مِمَّا يَحْتَاجُ إِلَيْهِ. He says to be consistent upon striving in increasing by never leaving striving. وَالْمُوَاضَبَةِ عَلَى وَظَائِفِ الْأَوْرَادِ مِنَ الْعِبَادِ وَالْإِشْتِغَالِ. And that the person, he's always coming with the types of worships of that time. He's worshipping Allah a lot. Ibadat and ta'at he's coming with. وَالْإِشْتِغَالِ قِرَاءَةً وَإِقْرَاءَ. And that he busies himself in reading, studying, وَمُطَالَعَةِ وَفِكْرَى. And also observing open books and reading. You see, مُطَالَعَ, researching. وَالتَّعْلِيقًا وَحِفْظًا, noting down things. Memorizing. وَالتَّصْنِيفًا, authoring. وَبَحْثًا, researching. You see, وَلَا يُضَيِّعُ شَيْئًا مِنْ أَوْقَاتِ عُمْرِهِ. And that he does not waste anything from his time. فِي غَيْرِ مَا هُوَ بِصَدَدِهِ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ وَالْعَمَلِ. Except that which is related to the knowledge and the actions which he is doing. And the time that he spends is what? إِلَّا بِقَدِّ الضَّرُورَةِ. It's in accordance to the necessity. مِنْ أَكْلٍ, whether it's like eating, or shurbin, drinking, or نَوْمٍ, sleeping, or إِسْتِرَاحَةٍ لِمَلَلٍ, or relaxing because of tiredness, or أَدَاءِ حَقِّ زَوْجَةٍ, or he's fulfilling the rights of a wife, or زَائِرٍ, or visiting, or تَحْسِيلِ قُوتٍ, or he's out there to gain provision and risk and food. وَغَيْرِهِ مِمَّا يَحْتَاجُ إِلَيْهِ. And other than that which he requires. وَكَمَا قِيلَ. And as it was said once before, my beloved brothers and sisters, لَا تَحْسَبِ الْمَجْدَ تَمْرًا أَنْتَ آكِلُهُ. لَا تَحْسَبِ الْمَجْدَ. Do not think honor, تَمْرًا أَنْتَ آكِلُهُ. Do not think that honor is like a date which you eat. لَا تَبْلُغُ الْمَجْدَ حَتَّى تَلْعَقَ الصَّبَرَ. And you're not going to reach honor until you show and you give patience. Al-Imam Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib rahimahullah. Al-Imam Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib rahimahullah. He said, إن كنت لأرحل الأيام والليالي في طلب الحديث الواحد. He said, I travel days and nights just for one hadith. I would actually cut distance. I will go land from land, day and night, just for one hadith. Ya'qub ibn Sufyan in his kitab Al-Fasawi, in his kitab Al-Ma'rifat wa Tariq, Al-Imam Al-Mizzi in his kitab Tahdhib Al-Kamal, Khatib Al-Baghdadi in his kitab Al-Rihlatu fi Talab Al-Hadith, also in his kitab Al-Jam' Al-Akhlaq Al-Rawi, also in his kitab Al-Kifaya, Al-Dhahabi in Tadhkirat Al-Huffaz, in his Sir Alam Al-Nubala, Ibn Sa'd in his Tabaqat Al-Kubra, Al-Ram Al-Hurmuziyu in his kitab Al-Muhaddith Al-Fasil, Ibn Abdul Barr in his kitab Jam' Bayan Al-Ilm wa Fadlih, Al-Hakim in his kitab Ma'rifatu, Ma'rifatu Ulum Al-Hadith, Al-Asqari, Abu Hilal Al-Asqari, Al-Hathi ala Talab Al-Ilmi, All of them, they brought it with the statement of Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib wa sanaduhu sahih, and his chain of narration is authentic. So you can see that Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib is saying to you, I did not hear of one hadith except that I traveled night and day for it. Just one hadith. And a person may be in a halaqah, or they may know a dars where they can learn 4 or 5 hadiths a day. And they won't go. And they won't go. And this, my brothers, shows us that أن معالي الأمور, the things that are very high in life, لا تنال إلا بالاجتهاد, that you're not going to gain it unless you put effort and hard work in it. And to remember that that ijtihad that you come with, inshallah ta'ala, is going to be for the cause or the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which you get rewarded for. ولذلك أبو عمر الحسن بن علي الحمد لله يهديكم الله ويصلح بالكم. Al-Imam Abu Umar al-Hasan ibn Ali ibn Muhammad ibn Ghassan al-Basri, he said, طلب الحديث طريقة الماضين من أهل الرشاد فاسلك سبيلهم تنل درجاتهم يوم الميعاد. Seeking hadith is the path of the previous people. من أهل الرشاد, from the people of wisdom and the people of guidance. فَسْلُكْ سَبِيلَهُمُ تَنَلْ, take their path and tread on it, you will gain. دَرَجَاتِهِمْ يَوْمَ الْمِعَادِ, you will gain their statuses and their ranks the day of judgment. He also said, الْعِلْمُ أَفْضَلُ شَيْءٍ أَنْتَ كَاسِبَهُ فَكُنْ لَهُ طَلَبًا مَا عِشْتَ مُكْتَسَبًا فَالْجَاهِلُ الْحَيُّ مَيِّتٌ حِينَ تَنْسُبُهُ وَالْعَالِمُ الْمَيِّتُ حَيٌّ كُلَّ مَنْ تَسَبَى. Ilm, knowledge, is the greatest thing in which you can go out to look for. Be one, فَكُلَّهُ طَلَبًا مَعِشْتَ, however long you live in this world, be one that looks for knowledge and one who wants to gain it. Verily the ignorant one is dead. And he comes out to the people and he's seen by, he's jahil, he's dead, he doesn't live. Meaning no mentioning of him. His presence is like his absence. وَالْعَالِمُ الْمَيِّتُ, but the dead scholar is really alive amongst the people. His mentionings are there. People are speaking about him. Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim rahimahullah, in his kitab Miftahu Dar al-Sa'ada, first volume, page 115, he says, كُلُّ مَا فِي الْقُرْآنِ مِنْ مَدْحٍ لِلْعَبْدِ. In the Qur'an, every praising there is in the Qur'an for the slaves. فَهُوَ مِنْ ثَمَرَةِ الْعِلْمِ, it is the effects of knowledge. It's the cause of knowledge. وَكُلُّ مَا كَانَ فِيهِ مِنْ ذَمِّ لِلْعَبْدِ, and anywhere where you find any rebuking, any scolding in the Qur'an, فَهُوَ مِنْ ثَمَرَةِ الْجَهْلِ, it is because of the outcome of ignorance. Al-Imam Hafidh ibn Hazm rahimahullah, in his kitab Al-Akhlaqi wa Siyar, page 27, he says, لَوْ لَمْ يَكُنْ مِنْ فَضْلِ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا أَنَّ الْجُهَالَ يُهَابُونَكَ وَيُجَلُّونَكَ وَأَنَّ الْعُلَمَاءِ يُحِبُّونَكَ وَيُكْرِمُونَكَ لَكَانَ ذَلِكَ سَبَبًا إِلَى وُجُوبِ طَلَبِهِ فَكَيْفَ بِسَائِرِ فَضَائِلِهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. Imam Ibn Hazm said, if it was not from the virtues of knowledge, except that the fact that the ignorant ones are going to respect you and that they're going to honor you, وَأَنَّ الْعُلَمَاءِ يُحِبُّونَكَ, and that the scholars will love you and that they will respect you, لَكَانَ ذَلِكَ سَبَبًا إِلَى وُجُوبِ طَلَبِهِ, that will be sufficient in it being obligatory for one to gain knowledge. فَكَيْفَ بِسَائِرِ فَضَائِلِهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ, then what about all the other remaining virtues in this dunya and in the hereafter? وَلَوْ لَمْ يَكُنْ, and if it was not, مِنْ نَقْسِ الْجَهْلِ, and if it was not for the deficiency of ignorance, إِلَّا أَنَّ صَاحِبَهُ يَحْسُدُ الْعُلَمَاءِ, except that the fact that the person is going to have jealousy towards the scholars, وَيَغْبِطُ نُظَرَاءَهُ, and that he's going to have غِبْط of the people who are level to him, مِنَ الْجُهَالِ, from the ignorant ones, لَكَانَ ذَلِكَ سَبَبًا إِلَى وُجُوبِ الْفِرَارِ عَنُهُ, the people who are like him, he would want them to lose what they have. Ah, he would have jealousy and hate towards the scholars. If that wasn't enough for ignorance, in terms of it being something to run away from, لَكَانَ ذَلِكَ سَبَبًا إِلَى وُجُوبِ الْفِرَارِ عَنُ. That would be enough for you to run away from ignorance. فَكَيْفَ, what would the matter be? بِسَائِرِ رَضَائِلِهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ, the other remaining evil traits that it has. As I said before, from the kalam of Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah, my beloved brothers and sisters, is what? Knowledge is something. لَا يُعْطِيكَ بَعْضَهُ, it will not give you some. حَتَّى تُعْطِيَهُ كُلُّكَ, until you give him everything you have. وَأَنْتَ إِذَا أَعْطَيْتَهُ كُلُّكَ أَعْطَاكَ بَعْضَهُ, if you give your all, it will give you something in return. وَاللَّهُ الْمُسْتَعَانِ. Also, my beloved brothers and sisters, the one who is seeking knowledge, if you do not become patient, إِن لَمْ تَصْبِرْ عَلَى تَعَبِ الْعِلْمِ, if you do not become patient upon the hardship that you have to endure while seeking knowledge, صَبَرْتَ عَلَى شَقَاءِ الْجَهْلِ, you will definitely be patient upon the harm and the evil of ignorance. اللهم سلم يا رب العالمين. Abdul Malik al-Asma'i, he said, and the statement of his, Al-Imam al-Bayhaqi brings it in his Al-Madkhal ila Sunan al-Kubra. He brings it from the Senate, min tariqi Abil Hassan Muhammad ibn Mahmud al-Kariziyy al-Faqih, who said, haddathana Abu Mudar, Muhammad ibn Mudar al-Ribatiy, who said, haddathana Abu Dawood Sulaiman ibn Ma'bad al-Baruzi, who said, sami'tu al-Asma'iyya, يقول, I heard عبد الملك الأصمعي رحمه الله saying, من لم يحتمل ذل التعليم ساعة بقي في ذل الجهل أبدا. The person who does not endure the humiliation of knowledge for a portion of time, he will remain in the humility of ignorance for the rest of his life. If you do not endure the humiliation of seeking of knowledge for a portion of time in your life, then know that you will remain in the humiliation of ignorance for the rest of your life. So you choose, which humiliation do you want to go through? A humiliation which is limited for a portion of time, and after that you become a person of knowledge, or a humiliation that is forever to be. You have to choose. And sadly, wallahi, you see students of knowledge sometimes, they want to learn knowledge without humiliating themselves, without humbling themselves. They want to gain knowledge with izzatun nafs. They want to have self-pride, self-esteem, and put themselves forward. No one gains knowledge, my brothers, unless he endures that humiliation and that humility. Another benefit or point that I wanted to mention in this, my beloved brothers and sisters, is Allah did not make the people the same. Allah did not make the people the same when it comes to seeking knowledge, and the people are different. وَقَدْ لَا يَتَيَسَّرُ لِبَعْضِ الطُّلَّابِ الْعِلْمِ, sometimes it may not be easy for some students of knowledge seeking a particular science or seeking in a particular manner. You see, لِضَعْفِ فَهْمِي, because his understanding is weaker, or لِعَدَمِ اسْتِطَاعَتِي, or his ability is very lower. So what does he have to do in this situation? Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he mentions in the 19th volume, page 119, he says, فَأَكْثَرُ الْخَلْقِ يَكُونُ الْمُسْتَحَبُّ لَهُمْ مَا لَيْسَ هُوَ الْأَفْضَلُ مُطْلَقًا. Pay attention. He says that the majority of the people, what may be recommended for them, may not necessarily be the greatest thing out there. Some people will say to you, them, this is best for you. But that which we recommended for them may necessarily not be the best thing out there. It may not be. Why? إِذْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَقْدِرُونَ عَلَى الْأَفْضَلِ, because the majority of the people are not able to come with the greatest thing out there. وَلَا يَصْبِرُونَ عَلَيْهِ, and they are not able to be patient with it. إِذَا قَدَرُوا عَلَيْهِ, even if they're able to do it, they can't be patient on it. وَقَدْ لَا يَنْتَفِعُونَ بِهِ, and they may not even benefit from it. If we push them to the fadl al-mutlaq, the unrestricted good that's out there, they may not even benefit from it. بَلْ قَدْ يَتَضَرَّرُونَ إِذَا طَلَبُوا, rather sometimes they may even endure harm from it. And they may suffer from it if we push them to it. مثل من لا يمكنه فهم العلم الدقيق إذا طلب ذلك فإنه قد يفسد عقله ودينه. Such as من لا يمكنه, the person who is not able to understand detailed matters of the religion. They can't. They're unable to understand it. That individual, if we push him to it and we say, that's the best thing out there, go for it. فَإِنَّهُ قَدْ يُفْسِدُ عَقْلَهُ. It may corrupt his heart, mind. وَدِينُهُ his religion. He also said in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, the 24th volume, page 198, وَقَدْ يَكُونُ الْعَمَلُ الْمَفْضُولُ أَفْضَلَ بِحَسَبِ حَالِ الشَّخْصِ الْمُعَيَّنِ لِكَوْنِهِ عَاجِزًا عَنِ الْأَفْضَلِ أَوْ لِكَوْنِ مَحَبَّتِهِ وَرَغْبَتِهِ وَاهْتِمَامِهِ وَانْتِفَاعِهِ بِالْمَفْضُولِ أَكْثَرَ فَيَكُونُ أَفْضَلَ فِي حَقِّهِ لِمَا يَقْتَرِنُ بِهِ مِنْ مَزِيدِ عَمَلِهِ وَحُبِّهِ وَإِرَادَتِهِ وَانْتِفَاعِهِ. Ibn Taymiyyah says, it may be an action which is less in virtue, less in good, than that which is greater than it. It may be recommended for a particular individual. It may be prescribed for a particular individual. Why? لِكَوْنِ عَاجِزًا عَنِ الْأَفْضَلِ, because he has no ability for the greatest one, the best of the ones. He can't do it. أَوْ لِكَوْنِ مَحَبَّتِهِ وَرَغْبَتِهِ, or maybe his love and his passion and his اهتمامي and his concern وانتفاعهِ and his benefit is with the المفضول, the lesser one in good. فَيَكُونُ, and because of that it will be for him أفضل في حقه, the lesser in good is good for him, it's the best for him. لما يقترن به من مزيد عملي وحبي وإرادتي وانتفاعي, because of the fact that what's connected to it is the action and the passion and the love and the drive that is in it for him. Allahu Akbar, look at this. There are two things. This is the best. But for a person, the best may not be the best for him. Why? Because even if he goes for this, he has no drive for it, his intentions, his will is not there. So he will probably not get as much out of the other one which is less that he would get from the one that's greater. So it's lack of wisdom to push him towards that. Even Sheikh AbdulRahman Nasir al-Sa'di rahimahullah, he mentions in his kitab Al-Wasail al-Mufida للحيات السعيدة, he mentions something like that. So it's good that you go towards it and you look at it. Also, what I have to bring to the attention and remind, especially لا سيما في حق المبتدي, especially the beginner who's starting, who's embarking on this path of what? في طلب العلم, in seeking knowledge. فإنه ينصح, it is advised to him بأن يقبل على ما تأنس به نفسه, that he goes towards that which his nafs is in passion and love of. لِأَنَّ ذَلِكَ أَدْعَى لِلِاسْتِمَرَّارِ طَلَبِهِ لِلْعِلْمِ, because the thing that you're passionate about is most likely, inshallah ta'ala, because you're passionate about it, that you're inshallah ta'ala going to carry on and you're not going to stop. But if you're pushed towards something you're not passionate about, you may stop seeking knowledge and you may leave the arena of being a student of knowledge. Until you carry on doing that, حتى إذا رسخت قدمه في طلب العلم, until your legs become rooted in seeking knowledge, then inshallah ta'ala you will start think, okay, maybe I want to go to this now. And maybe then, and maybe that. Inshallah ta'ala. Go to AbdulRahman Nasir al-Sa'di's kitab Al-Wasail al-Mufida fi Hayati al-Sa'ida, page 15, he mentions some, mashallah, good points regarding that. Junaid ibn Muhammad al-Baghdadi, rahimahullah, he said, an author that Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi narrated in his kitab Jam'u al-Akhlaq al-Rawi wa Adab al-Sami', he said, ما طلب أحد شيئا بجد وصدق إلا ناله. Nobody has ever requested something or went after something. No one's ever sought something, okay, with jid, with unwavering conviction, وصدق, and with truthfulness in them, sincerity. إِلَّا نَالَهُ, except that person will gain it. فَإِنْ لَمْ يَنَلْهُ كُلَّهُ نَالَ بَعْضَهُ, and if he doesn't gain all of it, he will gain some of it. But you have to come with jid and sidq. You have to come with what? jidd and sidq. Also, my beloved brothers and sisters, the people who want to gain this knowledge, a lot of them you find, they will leave the gatherings of knowledge. Majalisul ilm. They are absent from it. And that person, فَقَدْ خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. He has received calm and corruption in this world and his hereafter. He's lost. He won't gain anything. وَلِذَلِكَ الْإِمَامُ يَزِيدِ بْنُ هَارُونَ. And the same is narrated from Sufyan al-Thawri, rahimahullah. And Yazid ibn Harun, since he was after Sufyan al-Thawri, it's as though he took the statement from Sufyan al-Thawri, which is, مَنْ غَابَ خَابَ وَأَكَلَ نَصِيبَهُ الْأَصْحَابُ. You see, they say, yeah, they say, if you snooze, you lose. هذا هو. You snooze, you lose. If you're absent, you will lose. وَأَكَلَ نَصِيبَ الْأَصْحَابُ. And your companions and your friends will take what you missed out. They can take your portion. Yazid ibn Harun said that, and Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah, but Sufyan said it way before him. So it's as though he took it from him. So if you want to gain knowledge and you're not seen in the places where knowledge is sought, and you're not sitting with the people of knowledge, then you're not going to gain it. I want to finally conclude with one final statement, which is the statement of Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah, which he said in his Diwan. And this is shurutu tahsil al-ilm. The conditions of gaining knowledge. They are six. If you don't have these six, you're not going to gain knowledge. A student of knowledge who wants to gain knowledge, if he doesn't come with these six, don't waste your time. Don't busy yourself because you're not going to get anywhere with knowledge. And Imam al-Shafi'i said, أخي لن تنال العلم إلا بستة سأنبيك عن تفصيلها ببياني ذكاء وحرص واجتهاد وبلغة وصحبة أستاذ وطول زمان. My beloved brother, he said, أخي, my brother, لن تنال العلم إلا بستة. You are not going to gain knowledge except with six. You want to gain knowledge? You're going to gain knowledge with these six. If you want to gain knowledge, أخي, my brother, لن تنال العلم, you will not gain knowledge إلا بستة except with these six. سأنبيك, I will tell you about it, عن تفصيلها ببياني, I will tell you it's in details, inshaAllah ta'ala. The first one is what? Dhaka'un, you have to be smart. A person who's just heedless, who's ghafil, who doesn't know, huh? He won't get nowhere with knowledge. You have to be a smart individual. Wa hirsun, hirs is a person who has shiddatul raghba. He has excessive passion for knowledge. My brothers and sisters, أخي لن تنال العلم إلا بستة سأنبيك عن تفصيلها ببياني ذكاء وحرص. You have to have passion for this. You literally, in your heart, this is all you live for. Okay. واجتهاد, and you're striving. You are striving. So it's not just a رغبه, a passion in your heart. No. It's also what? Now it's, the effects are shown on your limbs. وَبُلْغَةٌ. Bulgha means ma yakfi lisad alhaja. You're a person who's content quickly. You're not a person who's always hungry more and more for dunya. You'll only take the minimum from the dunya. Wa suhbatu ustadhin, the companionship and the hanging around of a person of knowledge, a teacher. That's the fifth one. The sixth one is what? وَطُولُ زَمَانٍ. Time. A length and duration. Somebody goes and seeks knowledge for 2 weeks, and or 2 months, or 3 months, 6 months. He comes back, he thinks, why didn't I gain much? Knowledge, my brothers and sisters, it requires طُولُ زَمَانٍ. It needs time. So my beloved brothers and sisters, remember that statement. أَخِي لَن تَنَالَ الْعِلْمَ إِلَّا بِسِتَّةٍ سَأُنْبِيكَ عَنْ تَفْصِيلِهَا بِبَيَانِ ذكاء وحرص واجتهاد وبلغة وصحبة أستاذ وطول زمان. I want to also, my beloved sister, brothers and sisters, I know I said I'm going to conclude with that statement of Imam al-Shafi'i, but a point that is really needed, which is a lot of students don't do, which is that the knowledge is categorized into usul and furu'. Even that the Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah did not like this usage of furu' and usul, or dividing the religion into usul and furu'. Ibn Taymiyyah didn't like it. But he himself used it elsewhere in his Majmu' al-Fatawa and other places in his books. And there was a reason behind why he didn't like using it. And his reason is clear. Anyone who has studied it and looked at the works of Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, it is that if you do not take time out to learning the usul, the fundamental matters of the religion. لِذَلِكَ the poet, he said, the scholars, they say, sorry, more like, مَنْ لَمْ يُتْقِنِ الْأُصُولَ حُرِمَ الْوُصُولَ. Anyone who does not solidify the fundamental matters of the religion, he is prohibited from reaching his goal. أَمَا مَنْ حُرِمَ الْأُصُولَ حُرِمَ الْوُصُولَ. Anyone who is prohibited from the fundamental matters of the religion, he is prohibited from reaching his goals. If you don't learn usul al-fiqh, if you don't learn usul al-tafsir, if you don't learn mustalah al-hadith, which are fundamentals, if you don't understand them, then you're not going to really understand and you're not going to reach your goal. Then, my brothers and sisters, فَلَا بُدَّ مِنَ التَّأْصِيلِ. Foundate yourself. Come, place yourself upon a strong foundation. تَأْصِيلِ and تَأْسِيسِ. Build a very strong foundation. لِكُلِّ فَدٍ تَطْلُبُ. Every field in the religion that you're gaining knowledge for, try to learn a foundation of it. Okay? بِضَبْطِ أَصْلِهِ. By trying to make yourself understand the fundamentals of that field. You want to study fiqh? Have a good understanding of usul al-fiqh. You want to do tafsir of the Qur'an? Learn the usul of tafsir. You want to speak about hadith? Then learn the science of hadith. مُصْطَلَح al-hadith. Ulum al-hadith. You want to read Qur'an or you want to learn, what do you call it, tajweed and the sciences of that work for it. But then who do you read on? Ala shaykhin, mutqinin, athari. You read on a teacher who himself knows it very well. And he's an athari, salafi. A man of the sunnah. A man whose aqidah is not corrupt. And that will not deviate you from the straight path. Because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he told us in the Qur'an, in Surah Al-Qasas, ayah 26, Allah says, إِنَّ خَيْرَ مَنِ اسْتَأْجَرْتَ الْقَوِيَّ الْأَمِينَ. The best person to hire, to be with, is a person who is what? قَوِي. How is he strong? مُتْقِنٌ فِي الْأُصُولِ. He's strong in the sciences and he knows it. And he's strong in his aqidah. And he's a person who is what? He's أمين. He's reliable. He won't lie. He won't deceive you. He will give you the sciences and the knowledge the way it should be given to you. I'm going to quickly read on you kalam that Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he said in his liqa bab al-maftuha, when he was asked about anit talaqi anil ulama'i wal kutub, taking knowledge from the books and the scholars. He said, وَالصَّوَابُ أَنَّ الطَّرِيقَيْنِ الصَّحِيحَيْنِ التَّلَقِّي مِنَ الْكُتُبِ وَتَلَقِّي مِنْ أَفْوَاهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ وَلَكِنْ لَا بُدَّ مِنْ شَرْطٍ أَسَاسِيٍّ فِي هَذَيْنِ الْأَمْرَيْنِ وهو أن يكون المؤلف موثوقا في عقيدته وفي علمه وأمانته وكذلك نقول في المعلم لا بد أن يكون موثوقا في عقيدته وفي علمه وأمانته ولكن تلقي العلم من أفواه العلماء أيسر وأضبط وأسرع. Until he said, والذين اعتمدوا في علمهم على قراءة الكتب فقط نرى أن عندهم أحيانا شطحات بعيدة جدا عن الصواب لأنهم لم يتلقوها أما لأنهم لم يتلقوا عن علماء ناضجين لأنهم لم يتلقوا عن علماء ناضجين لكن إذا لم I think it's ناصحين لأنهم لم يتلقوا عن علماء ناصحين It's a mistake here, I think I wrote. لكن إذا لم نجد العالم الذي نتلقى من فيه فقرأ الكتب ثم إنه إذا قلنا أن التلقي من العالم أسرع وأحفظ فلا يعني ذلك أن لا يرجع الطالب إلى الكتب بل يرجع إلى الكتب ولكن رجوعا مقيدا بتوجيه العالم الذي يقرأ عليه. Ibn Uthaymeen here says benefits, and another statement of his in his Kitab al-Ilm, because I want to quickly explain it and give it the overall meaning. He says, لا بد أن يطلب العلم على شيخ متقن وذي أمانة لأن الإتقان قوة والقوة لا بد فيها من أمانة إن خير من استأجرت القوي الأمين وربما يكون العالم عند إتقان وسعة علم وقدرة على تفريع والتقسيم ولكن ليس عنده أمانة فربما أضللت فربما أضلك من حيث لا تشعر كذلك لا تأخذ العلم بالتحصيل الذاتي أي أن تقرأ الكتب فقط دون أن يكون لك شيخ معتمد ولهذا قيل من كان دليله كتابه كان خطاه أكثر من صوابه فالأصل أن من اعتمد على التحصيل الذاتي وعلى مراجعة الكتب أن يضل لأنه يجد بحرا لا ساحل له ويجد عمقا لا يستطيع التخلص فيه أما من أخذ من عالم شيخ فإنه يستفيد فوائد عظيمة الفائدة الأولى قصر المدة الفائدة الثانية قلة التكلف الفائدة الثالثة أن ذلك أحرى بالصواب لأن هذا الشيخ قد علم وتعلم ورجح وفهم فيعطيك شيئا ناضجا. The Shaykh rahimahullah, he mentions that there are two ways a person can gain knowledge. One can be by taking it from a scholar, and one can be by taking it from books. And the Shaykh emphasizes on the book that you take it from should be from a book that its aqeedah, the author who wrote it, his aqeedah is sound, and his belief and his faith in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is in accordance to the methodology and the belief of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Also, the teacher that you take from and which you take your knowledge from should also be the same. It should be a person whose understanding of the religion is correct and his methodology and his aqeedah is correct. And the Shaykh then emphasizes on the issue of that taking from a teacher is far greater than trying to take it from a book directly. Because when you take it from a teacher, it is asra' wa ahfad. It's quicker to take it and it is faster to memorize it. Also, taking it from the teacher helps you from falling into any deficiencies. Because the person who tries to study from books and tries to read himself, he is most likely, without a doubt, going to fall into the deficiency of falling into more mistakes than coming to correct stances. And he brought the statement of the scholars, مَنْ كَانَ دَلِيلُهُ كِتَابُهُ كَانَ خَطَاهُ أَكْثَرُ مِنْ صَوَابِهِ. Anyone who his guidance comes from the books, then his mistakes are far more than that which he gets right. And then he emphasizes that the asal is to rely on a teacher and a person of knowledge. And he tells us three benefits that it has if you take from a sheikh, a teacher. First one is the duration is very short. When you take from a teacher, you get to the what you're looking for quicker. But when you're trying to go to the books yourself, you don't know where to start with. You spend so many years of trying to know the books first before you, and then after that, you don't know which one should go first, and then you waste a lot of time. The second benefit that it has from taking from a sheikh is what? قِلَّةُ التَّكْلِفَة. There is less efforts that are involved when you have to take from a teacher than when you have to go to the book yourself. There's so much effort involved. And the third, which is أَنَّ ذَلِكْ أَحْرَى بِالصَّوَابِ. That the chances of getting it right is greater and it's more when you take it from a sheikh, alimin, mutqinin, a scholar who's solidified, whose understanding is correct, athari, who follows the textual evidence. Wallahu waliyu tawfiq, subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.